Welcome to Mawson Dock. Make yourself comfortable while we finish some preliminary ship checks. My name's Theo Acosta, and I'll be running your Pilots Federation evaluation. Most pilots assigned to me earn their license, so as long as you follow my instructions, you'll be a commander in no time. Oh, and before you ask, I may sound like an Imperial, but I'm actually from an independent system. Today we'll be covering the basics of flight control, combat, and frameshift drive use. This sidewinder has been installed with a specialized computer that'll take control at certain points. Mostly you'll follow a series of objectives to guide your actions. These are shown in the info panel at the top right of the head-up display. Okay, you're good to go. Select auto-launch from the options ahead of you when you're ready. Allows us to appreciate the good things in life. Other applicants are departing for their own evaluations, but this isn't a race. Each of the coming stages can be completed at your own pace. marker beside the throttle gauge. This indicates the optimum turning speed. So I advise slowing down to prevent any mishaps. Small, so you'll need to position yourself close to it. Watch your speed here. We intend to scan the object, not become one with it. You can scan the beacon now. Well done. The data link scanner is a versatile tool that connects with network interfaces and various data points. You need to move to another area of this star system to continue your assessment, pilot. Rather than travel for the next year using your thrusters, you can employ the ship's frameshift drive to increase your speed by a few orders of magnitude. First, ensure that the ship is correctly secured. Your landing gear, cargo scoop, and hardpoints must all be retracted. When you're ready, throttle up and engage supercruise. Assessment is going to take a rather long time.
Frameshift drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
All readouts look good. You're now accelerating towards a velocity comparative to the speed of light, measured in C. Supercruise is used to navigate within a star system, allowing you to cover significant distances in minutes. Usually you'll retain control in Supercruise, but on this occasion your ship's computer is following a preset path. This is a good time to familiarize yourself with a couple of the cockpit panels available to you. In the top left of your HUD is the comms panel, which displays pilot communications and contacts across several channels. The top right is your info panel. Entries here mostly relate to your ship's status, computer messages, and events happening around you. Ah, there we go. Welcome to Lightspeed. Cycling to a different fire group. You'll notice that your weapons are now listed on your HUD. Fire groups allow you to manage your hardpoints efficiently. Let's begin the combat evaluation. Destroy several of the canisters. Around large structures. Why not give them a try? Your cannon will automatically reload until the ammunition supply runs out. Meanwhile, your laser will fire until the capacitor is depleted, at which point it will need to recharge. Try targeting the canister you're aiming. Quota achieved. Let's dial up the challenge a notch, shall we? An unmanned craft has arrived nearby. These drones are used by the Pilots Federation as target practice, and they're quite harmless. To continue, bring the craft into your sights and open fire. This one is fitted with a shield generator. Helpfully, your burst laser is a thermal weapon, which excels at stripping away a target's shields. task of leaping between star systems appear trivial, never let this simplicity distract from the marvel humanity has achieved. Your next stop is Quello Station. This time we'll employ the Supercruiser Assist module to guide your approach. Open the external interface panel to your left and select the Navigation tab. Highlight the starport in the location list and then select Supercruise Assist. It's the second option. Whichever method you use, all ships must seek docking permission before approaching a landing pad. To request docking permission, open your external interface panel and select the Contacts tab. Then select Quello Station in the list, followed by Request Docking in the information panel. Landing pad 3. The compass will point towards your designated pad. Ships need to be within 7.5 kilometers of a starport for a docking request to be considered. must be deployed. The related dashboard indicator lights up if this has been done.
Landing gear deployed.
In a moment, the sensor display will switch to the precision approach display, which helps you accurately set belly down on the landing pad. Congratulations, Commander. Your evaluation has been successful, and a license is being assigned to you as I speak. We just need to finalize your credentials. Enter the hangar to exit this evaluation. It's time to blaze your own trail across the galaxy. The manner in which you do so is up to you. Your new ship, Commander. Your pilot's Federation license has been issued, and you're free to traverse the galaxy as an independent pilot. Before launching for the first time, allow me to quickly introduce the basic interface for mission contracts. Almost all pilots will use the mission board at some stage. A contract has been assigned to you. Active missions are displayed in the Transactions tab of the external interface panel. This time you'll need to travel to Mawson Dock in the Dromi system. You can select these destinations on the navigation screen of the external interface panel. If you'd like to practice your journey first, I recommend the training simulations accessed via the internal interface panel. To review what we've discussed, select your comms panel and scroll through the recorded text. I'll contact you at Mawson Dock if you decide to complete this mission. If you choose to take a different path, then I wish you luck, Commander.
Greetings, Commander.
Bienvenue, Commandant. Je suis...
Приветствую, командир. Это...
Greetings, Commander. This is Verity, your cockpit voice assistant, more commonly known as COVAS. My purpose...
Drive charging. Greetings, Commander. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Frameshift drive charging. Ready to engage. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage. Warning, taking damage. Hull integrity compromised. Warning, temperature critical.
Thank you.
tracking gear deployed.
Thank you.
Charging. 4, 3, 2, 1. Engage.
on approach to this facility.
Frameshift drive charging. Gear deployed. Okay.
Mark. Report to station services for more information, Commander.
Please be concerned with other vessels while traversing the main access corridor.
Incoming message.
In order to keep bay traffic flowing smoothly, please follow standard operating procedures and request docking permission before entering the starport. Thank you. Services at this starboard are constantly being updated. Remember to visit every time you pass through the system. We would advise pilots to please show consideration to fellow visitors. Slow down and maintain a reasonable distance from other ships inside this dock. This is a message to all commanders. Please reduce your speed when maneuvering your ship inside the docking bay. Access to docking bay facilities requires flight control authorization. Please submit a request before entering the docking bay. Docking bay access is bi-directional. Please keep the airlock clear at all times. Thank you. This is an important announcement. Security surveillance is in effect at this facility at all times. Any detected acts of violence will be met with an appropriate response.
You are clear to leave.